Do you understand all that English, though?
No, that was plenty of English. But
yeah, the document wasn't so specific.
Exactly,
in my opinion,
I was about to say that.
It was like a blanket.
It was a
document.
It reminds me of school, how you would sometimes write a project or something and just be going so vague until you have to break it down into there's no basis. But I mean, this when he mentioned digitization of major government operations such as procurement to achieve transparency and reduce leakages and everything, I was just thinking about the Nigerian public sector and how technology is so not a thing there.
Yeah.
I mean, when you visit offices, public service and all,
files on files.
So when we talk about this, the same thing you're saying. So the first thing that comes to my mind, I think about how Nigeria still doesn't know the accurate population number.
That's
we don't know how many
exactly.
we are. We don't have a database and everything.
Workers.
So these are the things that technology should be solving in government. And when we're talking about digitization, it's not just about, I don't really know what they try to do with technology, but these leakages and stuff they're referring to means that there has to be some infusion of technology mm-hmm. in public service.
I think that if anything, Atiku's document, while it is very vague, I think it kind of covers more aspects than the Next Level Manifesto, somehow. You know, I think he mentions a few things.
It was broader.
I don't know what the reality is, because I mean, it's, I think, very fancy to have someone sit down and say, okay, so these are the problems and these are the potential solutions.
Exactly.
So just
I was about to say that. Because he mentioned something about the establishment of a technology support program, and what the program is supposed to do is to meet demand for the latest technology, especially in software development. Like, how exactly do you, how do you want to achieve that? That's just my issue. As I was just going through this thing, I was like, okay, these things look like, they seem like very great plans, but then we need action. Like, we need steps that you can actually account for.
7-point agenda. I'm just saying.
Like, we need steps that we can actually say, okay, yes, we tick this one off the list. We have done this one. Everything just seeming, I want to be great in the future. How do you want to be great?
Right. And I think this is one of the reasons why, you know, the tech ecosystem is just also maybe intentionally not bothering themselves with this. Because it's like, we see what you guys are saying you want to do or what you have, you know, promised and stuff, but this is not a reality. This is like, what else do you want to do? What else is practical? Okay, so electricity, maybe. Ease of doing business, maybe. So I could vote on those bases. But when it comes to this whole tech thing, it's like,
it's safer in the future.
Kingsley Moghalu, on the other hand, also has a very vague description, really, of what he wants to do for the tech ecosystem.
Yes.
And there are questions around how that will affect the tech ecosystem, and even how it would have the that population see him, right? Mm. His manifesto is surrounded, or at least is built, rather, on three pillars, right?
Mm-hmm.
Build, innovate, and grow. That's his vision for Nigeria. And with regards to innovation, he also talked about protecting intellectual property with regards to startups and I'm not sure how much knowledge he kind of has when it comes to the tech ecosystem. Because he also did some visits. He made some visits to startups. He went to your CC Hubs. You know, we went to all of these places. And I think that it's quite sad that, you know, this has become the go-to for many of these guys. Like, okay, so when we want to talk about technology, let's just visit three or four startups. And after all, it's like, we know where your problems are, and we are going to fix them. You don't know, just a one-day visit, and they, you know that they spend just 15 minutes at this place, and then they go to the next place. It doesn't give you the required knowledge of exactly what the problems are. You know, have you read about these guys? What do you know that are the challenges they are facing right now? And what are the...
What have they been able to achieve
without even the government? So it's not you going back there and thinking, oh, they don't really have lights. Meanwhile, they have sorted out that. So it's like, we'll bring, give you electricity. It's like, we did that like 5 years ago, sir. You know, so I mean, I think that there's got to be a lot more intention, you know, that goes into knowing what the tech ecosystem needs. And the best way to do this is to talk to the guys who are there. But the problem now is most of these guys don't trust the government enough to want to have a conversation with them.
Exactly.
So how do we go forward?
even, I don't know if it's trust, but I think they don't trust that they have enough political will to carry out, you know, some of the things that they promised them, because they really have, I'm sure they have some conversation that we are not privy to, as in behind closed doors, and they discuss these things and all, but still speaking about, you know, the detachment from government and technology. I don't know why they just view technology as a very youthful thing. It's just for youth.
Yes.
I
mean, and it's like, it's not that serious.
It's not for, exactly, it's not that serious. It's just for just a bunch of guys, geeks, you know, that geeks rather, that, you know, do this technology thing. I remember we were discussing yesterday about the Atiku manifesto, his emoji manifesto, for instance. I mean, it's just something they feel is very catchy for youth. Anytime we talk about technology, I mean, giving a speech as an older person born in probably the 60s, or 50s, you see something about, oh, technology for the youth. I mean, technology is all encompassing, involves everybody, it should be part of government. True. So whenever I see the plans on technology, it's always very, I mean, that's why they visit these guys, like you mentioned, just go visit them and say, okay.
Let's not be as if we don't know that they exist. Because look at the issues that even this current administration is facing, where stuff like, you know, pensioners who maybe have been paid and getting the word out there. Mm. You know, I mean, if you promise, for instance, that, okay, you're moving on, or you are going to make sure that you're able to sign up and get your pension digitally. Mm. It goes beyond even solving that problem at the government level, but it also makes a lot more people digitally literate, you know, which is one of the promises, or at least the campaign agendas that, you know, I think one or two of them have. So, like, I don't know.
I really hope they can incorporate it, because when you think, whenever you have to do anything in Nigeria, any form of registration, you always have to register paperwork.
Exactly.
Even the biometrics that they claim to do. I mean, you have your fingerprints everywhere, and at the end of the day, you still don't have someone's database.
That's another thing that some people are worried about. I know somebody who did not do BVA. He said he's not, because his data is everywhere with banks, and he's not doing that whole BVA thing. And this is a tech guy. Like, I'm not even, people should not even stress me. So imagine, for instance, now that you talk about stuff like that, let us look at protecting your data as a Nigerian, you know, and then you involve the guys who are able to do that.
And you need this data to plan. I mean, it's funny. So, like I say, you can't plan for the Nigerian economy without having proper data. So, how do you want to know? I mean, when they talk about different you know, programs that they want to do, I even remember that was the argument surrounding the giving of 5,000 naira to vulnerable Nigerians or the poorest. But so, how do you know these things? What's the database? You want to feed children? What's the data? So,
at the time, they said we were working with the World Bank and one other agency to get them the data. And stuff like that. Again, some Nigerians will see it as you not thinking they're good enough to help out with that project. Look at even the Nigeria Air or Air Nigeria thing as well.
Nigeria.
The design was given to somebody, the website was not registered. It's just like the littlest things. Somebody even always gonna buy the domain.
Really?
Mm-hmm. But like four. And you put him to come and meet him and pay him the money. So anyway, we have shared with you what their promises are. If you'd like to let us know what your thoughts are, do you think that these are the real issues, especially when it comes to technology? Because, I mean, there's a million other things that Nigeria needs help with that they have promised to do. But technology is like our focus, you know, on the show. Next time on the show, we'll be looking at what a few tech enthusiasts and tech leaders, voices in the tech ecosystem in Nigeria, have said about what the future should be for the tech ecosystem. And maybe compare that with what the manifestos are saying, and we'll have that conversation. The polls are this weekend, and if you haven't taken anything from our conversation today, it is that you have a power to ensure that the things that are most important to you are addressed by the person you think is most worthy of that seat, both at the Senate level, local government, governorship, and the presidential level as well. So please, go out and vote. This is a very unusual message from us here. But talking about technology, INEC is also trying to, you know, use that to their advantage. So please make it worth everyone's while. Go out and vote. Will you be voting?
I will be. I will be voting.
Vote for me. For president.
Right.
In what year?
2019.
Funny Puppies recently had a lot of ties with the tech ecosystem. And
you know, to Sheila. I thought of it when we were rounding off, and I really didn't know what to
say. Kind of worms, but I think she even had them. You know what? She pulled out of the race. So.
Yeah,
it's cool. I will replace her.
No, don't do that.
I shouldn't. Okay.
I need to accept.
Replace. Episcopal.
But speaking of the elections, hopefully in 2023, I would make use of electronic voting. And speaking of technology and the elections in 2023 elections, because that was ruled out, you know, for this election. So.
All right, guys, on that note, we say thank you for watching today's edition of Text We Discuss. We're back next time. Subscribe to our channel. That's the most important thing, all right? Use your thumb. Vote and subscribe.
Yeah.
And leave a comment down below as well about your thoughts on our topic today. Am I forgetting anything?
No, I don't think so. Follow us on all our social media handles, at TextCityNG. I think that's about it.
See you next time.
Bye.